imagine airline reservations without computerisation. You imagine banking. Imagine the Apollo mission. If you look, when you buy something and someone scans that code that makes all retail supply chains work, that universal product code, every single Sabre, banking systems, census, social security systems, all that things have all been powered by IBM in the past. So now we're turning our eyes to the future and say, what, with one out of eight people on the planet who don't have safe drinking water, if we have farming techniques in many developing countries that rely on flood irrigation, which wastes at least 70% of water that's highly scarce anyway, you have a role for sensors and application of leading technologies that is not an inhibitor to profits. It's not a charity arrangement. It's something that has economic value. It has substance. It has a contribution. And we're right at the leading edge. If you look at smart grids and electricity, again, the numbers of people that don't have reliable electrical power in their world is significant. And also, we know of the carbon impact of electricity generation using some sources of energy, in particular coal. If you can manage down the peaks, you can reduce generation, you can make sure that our loss is lower, and we get more people, more access to electricity. They're all things that are actually possible. They're possible. And the money is not made by the inventors of these technologies, by the way. History has said 5, 6, 7 times, steamship, railway, steam engine, the internet. The inventors don't make the money. The appliers of the technologies make the economic impact. And so if we go to sustainability, sustainability is good business sense. Sustainability is really in the interest of the planet. It's in the interest of every one of us.